Students, in this video we are going to solve a problem on design of helical gears. I am going to read the problem. A pair of helical gears are to transmit 15 kilowatt. The teeth are 20 degree stub in diametral plane and have helix angle 45 degree. The pinion runs at 10,000 rpm and has 80 mm pitch circle diameter. The gear has 320 mm pitch circle diameter. If the gears are made of cast steel having allowable static strength 100 MPa, determine a suitable module and face width. Given sigma ES equal to 618 MPa, we know that sigma ES is the surface endurance limit. First, we will write down the parameters that are given to us. P is the power 15 kilowatt, which is equal to 15 into 10 to the power 3 watt. Phi is the pressure angle, which is 20 degree. Alpha is the helix angle, 45 degree. NP is RPM of pinion, which is 10,000 RPM. DP is pitch circle diameter of pinion, 80 mm, which is equal to 0.8 meter. DG is pitch circle diameter of gear, 320 mm, which is equal to 0.32 meter. Sigma OP is equal to sigma OG, which is given as 100 MPa equal to 100 Newton per mm square. Sigma ES is 618 MPa, which is equal to 618 Newton per mm square. First, we will find module and the phase width. M is module in mm and B is phase width in mm. Both the gears and the pinions are made of same material, which is cast steel. Therefore, pinion is weaker of the two wheels and our design will be based upon the pinion. First, we will find the torque transmitted by the pinion. The equation for torque is given by P equal to P into 60 by 2 pi NP. It is a very well known equation. We will put the value of power P, 15 into 10 raised to the power 3, and value of NP, which is RPM of the pinion, as 10,000 RPM. On solving, we will get the value of torque equal to 14.32 Newton meter. Next, we will calculate the tangential tooth load on the pinion. Tangential tooth load WT is given by T upon DP by 2. T is the torque and DP is the pitch circle diameter of pinion. We will put its value. T equal to 14.32 Newton meter and DP is equal to 0.08 meter. On solving, we will get WT equal to 358 Newton. Next, we will calculate number of teeth on the pinion. We know module is equal to diameter upon number of teeth. From this equation, we will get TP equal to DP upon M. We will put the value of DP is equal to 80 mm. So we get module equal to number of teeth on the pinion equal to 80 upon module. Next, we will calculate equivalent number of teeth on the pinion. The equation is, we know that TE equal to TP upon cos cube alpha. Alpha is helix angle. We will put the value of TP as we have calculated TP equal to 80 by M, and alpha we know helix angle equal to 45 degree, and after calculating we get TE equal to 226.4 upon M. Next, we will calculate tooth form factor for 20 degree stub teeth, because in question it is given that the tooth profile is 20 degree stub. For this we have to consult design data book, and for 20 degree stub teeth tooth form factor is given by y dash p equal to 0.175 minus 0.841 upon TE. So students, while solving this design problem, you have to keep design data book and calculator in your hand. We will put the value of TE as 226.4 by m, and we will get y dash p. We will get y dash p equal to 0.175 minus 0.0037 times m. Next, we will calculate the peripheral velocity by the equation v equal to pi dp np by 60, very well known equation. Dp is equal to 0.08 meter and np is equal to 10,000 rpm. We will get peripheral velocity is equal to 42 meter per second. Since this peripheral velocity is greater than 20 meter per second, we will find velocity factor, and for this we have to consult design data book. You can see that for v greater than 20 meter per second, the equation for CV, that is the velocity factor, is 0.75 upon 0.75 plus under root v, and we will put the value of v equal to 42 meter per second, and we will get CV equal to 0.104. We know that for helical gear, the face width lies within the range 12.5 m to 20 m. So let us assume that face width b is equal to 12.5 m. We have assumed the minimum value because we want to reduce the cost of the gear by reducing the material to be used for manufacturing the gear. We will apply Lewis equation, Wt equal to sigma op dot cv multiplied by b dot pi m dot y dash p. We will put the values that we are known to us. Wt equal to 358, sigma op given 100, cv we have calculated 0.104, phase width we have taken 12.5 m multiplied by pi m, and y dash p we have calculated 0.175 minus 0.0037 times module. Go through this slide. You can take notes by pausing the screen. Now, on solving this equation, we get 358 Wt, which is the value of Wt, equal to 72 m square minus 1.5 m cube. It is a cubic equation in m, and you can solve it with the help of your calculator or by using hit and trial method. After solving, you will get m equal to 2.3, and let us take m module equal to 2.5 mm. Therefore, our face width is b, which is we have assumed 12.5 times module, we will get b equal to 31.25 mm, and let us take b equal to 32 mm. In the next, now our gear is designed and we know the value of module and face width. Next step is we will check the gear for wear load. For this, we will first find the velocity ratio equal to VR dg upon dp, which is equal to 320 by 80 equal to 4. The ratio factor q is given by 2 into velocity ratio upon velocity ratio plus 1. So velocity ratio is 4, we will put the value and we will get ratio factor as 1.6. Next, we will calculate normal pressure angle phi n. We know that tan phi n equal to tan phi cos alpha. We will put the value of phi 20 degree and alpha helix angle 45 degree. So we will get tan phi n equal to 0.2573. So phi n equal to 14.4 degree. Now both gears and pinion are of cast steel, therefore EP equal to EG for cast steel, which is equal to 200 kilonewton per mm square. We know that EP and EG are Young's modulus of elasticity of material of pinion and gear respectively. We have converted its value to newton per mm square and we get EP equal to EG equal to 200 into 10 to the power 3 newton per mm square. Next, we will calculate load stress factor. The equation is k equal to sigma es whole square sin phi n divided by 1.4, this whole multiplied by 1 upon ep plus 1 upon eg. We will put the value of sigma es as 618, the value of phi n 14.4, ep eg 200 into 10 to the power 3, and after putting the values we will get the value of load stress factor as 0.678. Now we will calculate maximum wear load. The equation is given by ww equal to dp dot b dot q dot k upon cos square alpha. We will put the value of dp 80, phase width 32, q 1.6, k 0.678 upon cos square alpha, alpha as 45 degree, and after calculation we get maximum wear load equal to 5554 newton. And since this maximum wear load is very 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 much greater than the tangential load WT, so our design is safe from consideration of wear. So that is the solution to our design problem. So go through it once again. Bye, best of luck.